today, Fremont, Nebraska. Still in the roughing stage, it's still not quite smooth all the way around on the outside. Getting closer. You'll have to watch real close for the catches. Thousands of years, actually, that's basically the way it was done. Hundreds since Leonardo's design. There was other ways it was done before that. But it was all done with muscle power. Just a short period of time, really, since we had electricity. So we live in a almost a spoiled society. Fortunate society. What we got here? Getting closer. Nearly got this spot rounded off here, and once I do get that, I'll go ahead and I'll start gouging on the inside. I want to try and save the bark. The bark staying alive is a neat effect, and it looks really nice, and it's pretty. And pretty is important, not just function. Doing that, it's going to throw that bark right off of there. To 6,000 calories at least. Good workout for you. It'll either build you up or break you down. I don't know which. Almost all the material, probably about 90% of the whole thing, the materials can be bought at your local home improvement store. It does make you appreciate what we have today. You don't see a lot of this sort of thing in the old western. You see the blacksmith shop all the time. But they were doing this. This is what they had in their carpenter shops. You know, and all of them had their spindles on their stairways and all that. Well, that was done by somebody, usually in town. And they use a lathe probably very much like this one to build most of those towns. A lot of the spokes for the wagon wheels and stuff like that were turned in a lathe very much like this. Try and keep it smooth as I can while I'm going. I lost some more of the bark. I may not be able to save the bark. We'll see. I'm hoping. We shall see. Come on over this way so you can see the angle of what I'm cutting right now. With this type of a bowl, you got to be really careful. Light, easy cuts, or you'll get those catches, and then you got another thing to clean off. Here at this point now, this is the spot that I haven't quite got smoothed off. Everything else is pretty much ready to go other than this spot right here. And once we get that spot, then we'll be pretty much done on the outside and I'll start cutting on the inside. And that's basically how you do a bowl with the wing like that.